for Microsoft 365 tip for this month. This is one that came from some interactions I had with a client. They had a question about this, and as I dove more into it, actually preparing for today, I learned some new stuff about this particular tip and trick that I'm going to share with you. So it's related to Microsoft audit logs and mailbox auditing. And we'll kind of talk through this, and then I'm going to go in and demo this, show you some of how this works, and some of the interesting things about this that, to be honest, I'm not 100% sure I like how this is done. I might be nice to see Microsoft change some of this. But to start with, the Microsoft 365 audit log. If you aren't familiar with it, as an admin, this is something you should absolutely know about. The Microsoft 365 audit log is available in both the Compliance Center and in the Admin Center in Microsoft 365, and logs pretty much every activity that exists within Microsoft 365. I went through the website that lists them all and counted it was a couple months back now. I want to say it's up around 381, 382 activities, if not a few more, that are logged within the Microsoft 365 audit log. This audit log, it does change a little bit based on what licenses you have. You get a lot of them with just every license. There is a premium license that gives you a little bit more functionality. But what we were particularly interested in, and what this tip is going to revolve around, is audit logging of mailboxes, in particular owner activities on a mailbox. So if you go out, manage mailbox audit logging. So if you go look through the manage mailbox audit logging, there are a few things you need to do when you're enabling this. Most of the time, it is enabled already now, but you are going to want to go in and check, and I'll show you how this works, to make sure that audit logging is enabled for mailboxes. But there are different actions that are audited based on if you're an admin, if you're a delegate on a mailbox, or if you're the owner of a mailbox. And one of those, the one that came into question, was actually this send functionality, where you can see this is enabled for owners, and this is interesting. It says owners and admins. It is audited. It is not on, though, by default. This is also one that is part of the Purview Audit Premium. So this is an additional license to audit sending, and you'll see some of those in here, where it's search query is premium, send is premium, and there's a couple others that are in here. So this is for user mailboxes and shared mailboxes. If you get down into Microsoft 365 group mailboxes, certain actions are audited differently when it comes to group mailboxes. So really, when it comes to Exchange, auditing Exchange is a little different, I've found, than everything else. So the first thing, what you're going to want to do, if you are curious in auditing these, and what we were playing with, is you're going to go into PowerShell. And if you haven't installed the Exchange Online Management shell, you're absolutely going to want to go and install that. It's just going to be install module Exchange Online Management. I've already installed it in my environment here, so I'm going to bypass that. And then once it's installed, you can type in connect-exchange-online, and this will go out and connect to your Exchange Online environment. It's going to pop up my environment, log me in, all my credentials were saved in this Windows session, and log into my Exchange Online environment. The first thing, if this is not on, and this might be something you just want to check initially for all of your users, is, are my users' mailboxes actually enabled for auditing? And are they being logged? So it's just a get mailbox identity and identity, and then type in their email address. This will go in. You can see it's admin delegate audit log is set. If I wanted to go in and Yeah, it'll go in, see which actions are being logged. It's admin and audit. You'll notice the owner ones in this one. Going up here. Admin and delegate are being logged. Owner is not being logged. And that goes into that owner mailboxes or owner actions on a mailbox aren't logged by default. Right here, by default, only non-owner mailbox audit logging is enabled and owner audit mailbox log is disabled. If you have to perform owner mailbox audit logging to investigate a specific issue, you can temporarily enable the process. Here it says for a two-week period. What I haven't tested out yet is this two-week period, does Microsoft automatically turn it off after 2 weeks, or is it a recommendation? Because in other places, they say it's recommended to only keep it on for 2 weeks. The reason being, and this is the one I don't know 100% what the reasoning is for this, these audit logs are actually stored in the user's mailbox. They're not stored in another location. So when this is on, it's possible to actually, and I think they're stored in the deleted items folder, like that hidden deleted items folder, not the mailbox. Yeah, right here. This is where it said for a limited period, approximately 2 weeks. It's because the audit log entries are stored in the mailbox and it may cause the mailbox dumpster, which is the deleted items, to exceed the size limit. So if you're going to turn this on, you have to be aware of that. So this is another PowerShell script we wanted to go look at. So for mine, let's go in, make sure my auditing is enabled. So this is how you can check if auditing is indeed enabled for the mailbox. For mine, it's true. But then if you want to audit those activities, you actually need to go in and set mailbox and set the user identity and set that audit enabled to true. Mine is off right now. So I could go in and type this on, audit enabled, set it to true, and this would go enable it. So we already did that. Mine was true. I don't need to worry about that step for my mailbox. I think I misspoke there. That is, if that came back as false, you'd want to run this. Now, if you want to go enable the owner audit logging, there's a separate commandlet to go set the mailbox and set the audit owner, and then what you actually want to audit for those owner activities. So this would go in and say, I want to audit as the owner of my own mailbox when I create something, hard delete, move to deleted items, soft delete, update. These all come from this other link that I had. Let's jump back here. When we went down here and looked at this, this is going to be the hard delete, the create, and the send. And in the particular case when we were going through this, we were curious about auditing all the send commands on a mailbox. So if you wanted to audit those, you would jump forward to this. Let's go grab this commandlet and we'll paste it in here. You would have to add send. So the sample that Microsoft gives doesn't have send on there by default. Go in here, we can set the mailbox and we're going to go enable this for my mailbox now. So this goes in now and actually starts auditing all those activities for my mailbox when I'm performing them as the owner. This is going to start enabling those activities now for that particular, or for my mailbox. So now if I want to go in and actually start auditing these, I can use PowerShell to do the whole search thing. But now if I go back to my audit log, so I'm back in my compliance center, you'll see I ran a couple searches already. What we could do, and I can show this. So I turned this on once on the 4th. I turned it off again on the 11th. So I did not audit any of my own send activities before the 1st. So if I was to go in here and say, I want to search for anything in my audit log from like the 1st of March to the 1st of April. And for my particular user, so I'm going to go pick my user, activities to search for, and these are those 380 some odd activities you can audit. The one we're interested in is sent messages. So I can go in. So now I'm looking for March 1 to April 1, any messages that were sent by me. I'm going to go in and trigger a search for that. We'll see how long this takes to complete. It'll pop up down here. It queues it up and go runs the search. You can see some of these do take 4 or 5 minutes to run. On the flip side, if I'm going to go in and run another one, and we may just go in and look at this one. I ran this one from April 1 to April 12. Same thing. My mailbox looking for sent messages here. If I go open this up, you will see an audit log of all of those mailboxes or all of those sent messages. You'll see a list of all the messages that I've sent over a period of time, and you'll see that it cuts off at April 11. It hasn't picked up any emails that I sent actually late last night or early today. And if I go back, even though I set it to start on the 1st, I don't have a single message before April 4 when I turn this on. So the one downside of this, and I sort of get why it's done, maybe not fully, is that if auditing is not enabled for the owner, you can't go back and historically search, at least in the audit log, for sent messages. This is only turn it on. When you turn it on, it starts auditing. Microsoft recommends don't leave this on for 2 weeks. So if you want to go like 4 or 5 weeks, you may have issues. Now, there are other ways you can see what people have sent. You still have e-discovery to look at sent messages. You can do legal holds. You can do retention. A lot of those other things, but you're not going to have the audit logging. I'm not going to go in and click on actually one of those items. It does show you like who I sent it to, what the subject of the email was, all of that. But that is how the audit logging works. Again, a little bizarre. It raised some questions because I have clients that have gone out and paid for the E5. They have the premium and they're like, why am I searching for sent messages and I'm getting zero results? As you'll see, I'm going to go refresh this. We'll see if it's finished yet. It hasn't, but you'll see this has been running for 2 minutes. It has zero results. This will come back with zero results for that time frame because auditing wasn't on. So it raised a lot of questions and confusions. Originally, when I was testing this, I thought it would go back in time, and it was just that it wasn't showing the audit log. It's that these activities are not actually saved because of that location where they're saved. So once you're done doing that investigation, you can go set the audit owner here to none instead of all these activities. And that will go in, turn it off so you don't fill up your deleted items in your mailbox. But then you won't also return any of those sent items anymore in your audit log. So a little odd, but also something good to know if you are wanting to search for those sent messages or have those audited for a period of time. I don't have any other explanation. The only thing I can think of is why Microsoft might do this is it does look at like the admin and the delegate. Some of those other things, because typically when a mailbox is compromised, stuff is getting sent as the app or there's other activities going on. And there are also other protections in Exchange Online where if a mailbox is compromised and it's sending out a bunch of bulk emails, like your outgoing spam protection and some of that will catch it. Or if you have rules around mail forwarding rules getting set up, this is, I don't know if it's geared more for if you have third-party applications that are tied into your environment that are sending out messages. Those types of things will be audited kind of under that delegate set. It's an interesting scenario, but again, something to be aware of.